हमाद एम आई ऑडिबल? हमाद आर यू देयर? हेलो गुड इवनिंग पीर, पीर आर यू देयर? Can you please confirm if I'm audible or not? All right. And Hamad, are you there?
Yes, sir. Good evening.
Good evening. Okay, guys. So we will wait for 2 more minutes. Maybe Halima also join. And if she didn't join within 2 minutes, and then we will start. All right, guys. So we were talking about the bill of exchange.
Yes, sir.
And in the last class, we have discussed questions based on this honor we have already done. Endorsement is also, I think we have done questions based on dishonor only.
Yes, sir. You gave us one homework.
I gave you one question as homework also. All right, so just a minute. Dishonor of bill of exchange, okay? We have done these questions in class. And this one also we did in here only. And I think we have also completed this question number 70. Yes? But I gave you this as homework.
No, sir, not this one. We did it.
Question 18.
That question was about that. Rolly and okay. Pulley. Yeah, this one, sir.
So, everyone, Peer, you did this question? Peer.
Yes, sir.
Completed question, this question?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Hamad, do you have any doubt? You want me to show the solution? This is the solution of the question. General entry in the book of poly. So, just match your solution with this. And let me know if you are not able to understand anything. Also tell me if
sir, in this we should only make drawer account, right?
Sorry?
Only the drawer account we should open, right?
In the given question, only drawer account is required. Therefore, only poly account has been. We generalize all the entries in the book of poly only. Shall we move to the next question, Hamad?
Yes, sir.
So 1 minute.
You are writing it down?
No, sir. I'm checking, sir.
You're checking.
Okay, sir.
So, guys, we will do one more question and then we will start a renewal of bill of exchange. And we'll be doing a question based on the renewal itself. So, okay. So just to recall everything, we will be doing this question. And this will be a kind of revision for you, because we have already done a similar question in the previous sessions. All right, a bill for rupees 1000 is drawn by A on B, accepted by the later payable at the New Delhi Bank of India. So what entries should be passed in the book of A under each of the following circumstances? If A retained the bill till the due date, then realize it on maturity, what should be the general entry? And if A discounted it with the bank, then what should be the general entry? If A endorsed it to C, and if A sent it to his bank for collection. So will you be able to solve this, Ahmad and P?
Yes, sir. I'll try.
I'll try, sir.
Please try this question. Do it fast. Make sure you do it within 5 to 6 minutes. Because this one is very easy, and this, because we have already done a similar question, so I'm sure you can easily do this within 5 to 7 minutes.
Okay, sir.
Halima, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Why are you joining so late?
I was checking the timing, so I remember that it's like this time.
Okay.
Sorry.
All right, Halima. So I have given this question to solve this. And please try this question. Let me know the solution. Let me know the answer. I'm giving you 5 to 7 minutes. Solve it within this time.
Okay.
Done.
Done. Hamad is done. Okay. Peer and Halima. Still doing?
Yes, doing.
Okay. So for just tell me the treatment of the first situation. Anyone? Hamad, please tell me the how did you treat the first situation, first circumstance?
In the book of A, right?
Sorry?
In the book of A, right?
Yeah, in the book of A only.
The first one will be the bills receivable account to B's account.
Mm-hmm.
The rupees will be 1,000.
Correct. Very good. Then?
Then second one will be C's account debit.
C's account debit?
To bills receivable account.
Why is C's account debit? You're doing question number 19, no? So, first of all, we will be doing the entry for the drawing of the bill. So, bills receivable account debit to, tell me, B, correct?
Yes, sir, yes.
So, this is the first general entry. After this, as per the circumstance first, it is written that if A retained the bill till the date of maturity, then it means the bill will be encashed on the due date and the payment will be received by Mr. A only. So in that case, transaction will be, general entry will
bank
be
bank account debit, right?
Sorry?
Bank account will be debited to bills receivable account.
Correct. Bank account debit to bills receivable. This is the situation number one, general entry for the first situation. See. So bills receivable account debit to B, and on the ordering of the bill, bank account debit to bills receivable account. All right.
Yes.
Now let's talk about if A discounted it with his bank for rupees 950. This is situation number B. If A discounted it with his bank for the 950. So the for situation B also, the first entry will be same, no? First entry will be bills receivable account debit to B. This will be the same.
Yes, sir.
Yes. And for the circumstance second, we will have to write it as, because we are discounting it with the bank, so bank will be giving us 950. And discounting charge in this case will be 50 rupees. Right? So bank account debit to discounting charge account debit to bills receivable account. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. It's correct.
Halima, is this correct? General
yes, entry sir.
Once again. Okay.
Yes.
So see, this is how it will be recorded. Situation B. Bills receivable account debit to B and bank account debit to discount account debit to bills account. Bills pay, bills receivable account. So for the time being, just avoid the last entry for the dishonored bill. We will be talking about it later. Now, if A endorses it to his creditor C in full settlement, so the again the first journal entry will be same, bills receivable account debit to B account. But for the endorsement, tell me, Peer, what will be the journal entry for the endorsement of bill of exchange? What will be the journal entry for the endorsement of bill of exchange, Peer? A is endorsing it to C, so what will be the journal entry for the endorsement of bill of exchange? Peer, are you there? Are you listening? Am I audible now? Please tell me the answer. Peer. No response. I think I'll have to talk to the parents, because most of the time you do not respond during the session. All right, Halima, can you tell me the general entry for the endorsement of bill of exchange?
It will be C's account debit to bills receivable account.
Very good, nice, good. And okay, so tell me, Hamad, the general entry for the final transaction D, if A sent it to his bank for collection.
Yes, sir. It will be B's account debit.
It will be B account debit.
A's account debit.
No. So first of all, just keep this in mind. Whenever you are generalizing the transaction in the book of A, name of A will never be mentioned in any journal entry. Getting my point? In the book of A, no name of A will be written. So first of all, because we are sending it to the bank for collection, so bills sent for collection account debit to bills receivable, this will be the journal entry, Amar.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay, sir.
So make sure before attending every session, make sure you revise the previous things we have discussed in the chapter. At least the main topics you have to revise. Like we have discussed the dishonor of will, so just look at the general entry for the dishonor, and we have discussed the endorsement, then discounting. So you just have to keep all those general entries in mind. And if you keep on revising things, you will find it easy. If you are not revising it enough, then you will find the things will get started to get difficult for you. All right. So make sure you revise things on a regular basis.
Okay.
Now, so for the first general entry for the bills sent for collection will be bills sent for collection account debit to bills receivable, and one more general entry will be done in this case, that will be for the collection of the bill. So bank account debit to bill sent for collection account credit. Correct?
Yes.
This is how it will be recorded. Situation D. Bills receivable account debit, bill sent to bank for collection. And if it is collected on the due date, so it will be bill. Bank account debit to bill sent for collection account debit. Okay, so I hope everything we have discussed up till now is clear to all of you. See, before moving forward, let me just recall what are the topics that we have already covered in this chapter. And whenever you revise, make sure you revise at least these topics. I'm not saying that you start doing each and every question of this chapter, but just keep this in mind. You have to at least look at these journal entry, like for the drawing of bill, we have understood how journal entry is done for the drawing of bill. All right. Then we have did the payment on maturity. If payment is being received on the date of maturity, then what will be the general entry? So payment of bill of exchange, or this is also known as honor of bill of exchange. So you must keep this in mind. Other than this, you have to also understand the general entry for the endorsement of bill of exchange. And then for the dishonor bill of exchange, dishonor, and bill sent for collection. So until now, until this point, we have discussed all of these topics. Bill sent for collection. So today we will be doing one more topic, and this is going to be, I think this is going to be the last topic of the chapter, that is renewal of bill of exchange. Renewal of bill of exchange. All right, everyone. So let's start with the meaning of the renewal of bill of exchange. So what is actually renewal? Renewal basically means, renewal of bill means issuance of the new bill by the drawee. Issuance of new bill of exchange, new bill of exchange by the drawee. All right, this is called renewal of bill. So why it is issued? So why new bill is required? See, what happens though, sometime when bill get dishonored, when bill is dishonored, it required to be cancelled, right? When bill get dishonored, then a new bill is drawn by the drawee. In case of dishonor of bill, new bill has to be drawn by the drawee. This is known as renewal of bill. So this basically renewal process is applicable mostly when a bill get dishonored. Getting my point? So in that case, we have to drawee have to issue a new bill, that is known as the renewal of bill. So in case of renewal of bill, there are certain entries that are required. So entry will be required for the canceling of the bill. Then when you issue a new bill, in that case, you will also have to pay the interest. So for the entry will be required for the interest as well. All right. So we will have to basically do few entries in case of renewal of bill of exchange. We will be looking at those entries. So try to be very, very attentive during this. Let me explain you how renewal is, what is actually renewal and what are the general entries.
Can you show that page one thing?
Sorry?
You can show the previous that note, which was writing.
Just a
minute. Done, sir.
Okay, so let's read this definition about sometimes the acceptor expresses inability to meet the bill on due date and requests the holder, that is the drawer, to substitute the old bill with a new bill. So there may be genuine reason that drawee is unable to meet the obligations of the bill, and he therefore requests drawer to bill a new, basically draw a new bill of exchange. The purpose is to get an extension of time. If the drawer agrees, the old bill is cancelled and a new bill is drawn and accepted by the drawee. This process is called renewal of bill. In such a case, there is no need for getting the bill noted. Like in case of dishonor, you must remember that in case of dishonor of bill, bill is required to be noted with the notary public, right? But in case of the renewal of bill, there is no notary involvement of notary will be there. There will be no involvement of notary will be there because it is already agreed between the drawer and the drawee that I'll be issuing a new bill replacing the old bill. So there is no requirement of the notary. It is not required to be noted with the notary public. So in such case, there is no need for getting the bill noted since the drawee himself makes a request for cancellation of the bill. Normally, for the drawer agreeing to this bill, drawer will charge interest. This is very, very important. Generally, when drawer agree for the renewal of bill, he agrees on the terms that he will be collecting, he will be charging some interest for the extension period. Let's say if he's allowing 2 month period, two or 3 month or 6 month extension, then he will be charging the interest for that particular time period. All right. The amount of interest may be paid in cash, or it can it include in the amount of the new bill. So either drawee may choose to pay this interest amount in cash, or he may choose to pay the amount along with the payment of the new bill. But I mean, the interest amount can be included in the amount of the new bill only. The interest will depend on the amount of the bill, the rate of interest and period of the new bill. So what will be the interest rate? It depends upon the amount value of the bill and the extension period being allowed by the drawer. All right, everyone. Hamad, Halima, Peer. Is this clear? Renewal of bill is clear to all of you? Why renewal is done? Renewal is done sometime due to the dishonor of bill. Renewal is done sometime because the drawee is unable to meet the obligation on the due date. Therefore, he requests the drawer to make a new bill of exchange. Okay, now the question arises, what kind of general entities will be passed while issuing a renewal, while doing the renewal of bill of exchange? So general entries will be different in both the books, in the book of the drawer as well as in the book of the drawee. So in the book of the drawee, first general, see, there are various general entries required to be entered here. So first general entry will be for the cancelling of the original bill, right? Because the original bill will now not be paid by the drawee. Therefore, we require to cancel the earlier bill, right? The original bill. So in order to do that, what will be the general entry? General entry will be drawee account debit to bills receivable account. Getting my point? Drawee account debit to bills receivable account. This will be the cancelling entry in the book of the drawer. We are debiting the drawee account. That means, let's say Hamad and P.
Yes, sir.
They are drawer and drawee. Hamad is the drawer of the bill. Peer is the drawee of the bill. So when Hamad is cancelling the bill, he will be writing the name of the drawee. Peer account debit to bills receivable account. All right. But on the other hand, drawee will be writing in his book bills payable account debit to drawer account. This will be the general entry for the cancellation of the bill. Halima, Peer and Hamad. Tell me, is this clear? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Drawee account debit. So basically we are canceling the bill now. So therefore we are crediting the bill. So bill of exchange, bills receivable are what? Bills receivable are generally asset. So bills receivable is credited. That means our bills receivable are reducing. And because we are canceling, so it must be reducing. Therefore we have again debited the drawee account and credited the bills receivable account. That means original bill is now canceled. Okay, now the second entry will be for the issuance of the new bill, and new general entry will also be for the interest being paid by the drawee. So the general entry for the interest for the extended period will be drawee account debit to interest account. This is the general entry for the interest due. Interest is due, but it is not paid. So the general entry will be drawee account debit to interest account. On the other hand, in the book of the drawee, the general entry for the interest will be interest account debit to drawer account. So it is just opposite of the entry in the drawers. Is this correct? Drawee account debit to interest account for the interest due. Tell me, is this correct, everyone? Peer, Hamad, do you have any doubt? All right. Now, for the third thing, part payment received. Sometime the drawee pays a part of the total bill at the time of the renewal of the bill. Let's say original bill was of, for example, 10,000. He is basically asking you to make a new bill, but he is also paying 2000 before the formation of the new bill. That means the part payment is received and for the remaining balance, new bill is required. So in that case, cash account debit to drawee account will be the general entry. Let me explain this in detail. Okay, see, let's say originally the bill was of original bill of rupees was of rupees 2000. Okay, so this bill is getting cancelled. So the first general entry will be for the cancelling of the bill, right? General entry will be for the cancellation of the bill of exchange. And as I told you, in the book of the drawee, in the book of the drawer, the general entry will be drawee account debit. Drawee account debit to bills receivable account. And the second general entry will be for the interest. So let's say drawee is saying that he want to create a new bill and he will be making payment after 3 month period. So basically he needs 3 month extension. So in that case, he will be imposing a three month interest. So in that case, the general entry for the interest will be, drawee account debit to interest account. Correct. Now, what happens sometime that let's say renewal of bill is, he's asking you to renew the bill, but at the same time, he is also saying that out of the 2000, he is ready to pay 500 and he asks you to make a new bill for the remaining balance. He is in a position to pay the 500 rupee. So he will be paying that in cash and the remaining amount he will be paying after 3 month period. So for this, you will have to make a renewal of the bill. You will have to make a new bill, but this amount is basically being paid by the drawee immediately on the due date. So in that case, the general entry will be for the payment, part payment of the bill. It will be, tell me, the general entry will be cash account debit to drawee account, right? So cash account debit to drawee account. This will be the general entry in the book of the drawer on part payment receipt. Tell me, Hamad and Halima, Peer, is this correct? Any doubt?
Yes.
Halima, any doubts?
No doubt.
No, sir.
And in the book of the drawee, the general entry will be obviously drawer account debit to cash account. Now, finally, new bill will be drawn. When new bill will be drawn, what will be the general entry? So it is very simple. Bills receivable account debit to drawee account as usual. The general entry we usually do, no? This general entry we usually do when bill is drawn. Bills receivable account debit to drawee account. This is the same general entry. Bills receivable account debit to drawee account. The same entry we do when bill is accepted, right? For the acceptance of bill also, we do the same entry, Hamad. So this is the same entry. Bills receivable account debit to drawee account. But this will be the by lesser amount this time. And in the book of the drawee, drawer account debit to bills receivable account. All right, everyone. So let me show you again. One more time, general entry for the renewal of bill will be for the, first of all, we will be doing it for the cancelling of the original bill. So that this will be drawee account debit to bills receivable account. And the second general entry will be for the recording of interest. This will be drawee account debit to interest account. And finally, in the book of the drawer, if part payment is being received, then cash account debit to drawee account. And finally, on the generation of the new bill, bills receivable account debit to drawee account. Okay. So let's do one question based on the same concept. This is the question, guys. Read it properly. A sells good to B for rupees 10,000. A draws a bill on him for the same amount for 3 month period before the due date. B requests A to cancel the bill before the due date. B requests A to cancel the bill, to accept 3000 as part payment and to draw a fresh bill on him for rupees 7200 for a further period of 2 months, rupees 200 being the interest for the extended period. So interest amount is already included in the bill, in the new bill. A agrees to the proposal. Finally, A agrees to the proposal, and the new bill is duly honored. And new bill is honored on the due date. Pass the necessary journal entry in both the books. So guys, first of all, write down the journal entries in the book of A. Prepare the format of the book of A and start recording the journal entry in the book of A. So first journal entry will be in the book of A. What will be the first journal entry? Anyone? In the book of A. That is in the book of the drawer. In the book of the drawer. So in the book of the drawer, the first journal entry will be for the sales of goods, right? For the sale of goods, the journal entry will be for the sale of goods. Tell me, what will be the journal entry for the sale of goods? PL. A sells good to B for rupees 10,000. What will be the journal entry? Halima, please tell me the journal entry.
It's B's account debit to sales.
B's account debit to sales, correct?
Yes.
B's account debit to sales amount will be 10,000. Okay. Hamad, tell me the general entry, second general entry. This was for sale of goods. Second general entry will be for the acceptance of bill, right? So for the, what will be the general entry for the acceptance of bill, Hamar? Hamar, what is the general entry for acceptance of bill?
Bills receivable account debit to B's account.
Very good. So bills receivable account debit, 10,000 to B account, 10,000. Okay. Now, on the due date, what is happening on the due date? It is written that on the due date, B requests A to cancel the bill. Okay. So we will have to cancel the bill, right? So tell me the general entry for the cancellation of the bill. Peer, what will be the general entry for the cancellation of bill? Okay, Halima, please tell me what will be the general entry for the cancellation of bill?
B's account debit to bills receivable.
Yeah, just opposite of this transaction, this general entry. So B's account debit 10,000 to bills receivable account 10,000 again. All right. Now we have to issue a new bill. But just a minute. Okay. Tell me the general entry. We will be writing the general entry for the interest, due, no? What will be the general entry for the interest due in the book of the drawer? Tell me, general entry for the interest due.
B's account debit to interest.
B's account debit to interest. B's account debit to interest. Hamad, you are getting this?
Yes, sir, I'm getting.
B's account debit to interest. What will be the rate of interest? Sorry, what will be the amount of interest? It is already given in the question. 200 is the amount of interest, right? 200 is the amount of interest. It is already given in the question. You are able to locate it?
Yes, sir.
In the fourth line, you will find it. 200 being the interest for the extended period. And one more thing is happening here. B is requesting A to cancel the bill and accept 3,000 as a part payment. So only 7,000 will be due, including the interest amount. So part payment is being received. So we will have to generalize the transaction for the part payment. Yes or no? Part payment received. What will be the generality for the part payment received? Anyone? For the part payment received, the general entry will be Hamar. For the part payment, what will be the general entry? Cash is coming now and it is coming from B. So tell me the general entry.
It will be cash account debit.
Cash account debit. Very good. And it is coming from?
Bank.
No, it is not coming from bank. No, cash is already B.
Yeah.
And value will be 3,000, right?
Yes, sir.
3,000. So we have done the transaction for the canceling, for the interest, for the part payment. So I think one more transaction is required for the issuance of bill, for issuance of new bill. Tell me, what will be the general entry? And Halima will answer this. Issuance of new bill. What is the general entry? For the issuance of bill, new bill, what will be the general entry? Bills receivable will be received, no? Bills receivable account debit. And this time bills receivable will be save 7,200. And it will be received from B. So bills receivable account debit to B account. 7,200. Tell me, Halima, is this correct? Hamad, is it?
Yes.
Read out.
It's same like acceptance of bill.
Yeah, exactly. It is same like the acceptance of bill. That is what I was telling you. It is exactly same as the acceptance of bill. There will be no change. Tell me, guys, is this correct, everyone? Do you have any doubts?
No, sir.
No doubt.
Hamad, any doubt?
No, sir.
No. So can you just write down the general entry in the book of the drawing? Everyone, I have solved one part. I want you to solve the other part in the book of the drawing. Just pass the general entry in the book of drawing. Let me know the answer. So in the book of the drawing, first general entry will be for the sale of goods, right? Then for the acceptance of bill. Then for the cancellation of the bill. It will be just vice versa. Whatever you are doing here in the book of the drawing, you will be doing just opposite of it. So for the cancellation of bill, it will be bills payable account debit to A account. For the interest, it will be interest account debit to A account. Right? For the payment of bill received, it will be A account debit to cash account. And for the issuance of bill, it will be A account debit to bills payable account. Getting my point, Halima and Hamar?
Yes, sir.
Will you be able to do this?
Yes, sir. So, sir, for the book of A, the drawer, right? First entry was B's account debit to sales account. So it will come A's account debit to cash account.
Mm-mm. In the book of the drawing. What did you just said? Sorry, for the purchase of goods, what will be the general entry?
A's account debit.
Mm-hmm. No. For the purchase, Droi will be writing purchase account debit. No, Hamad.
Oh, yes, sir.
Purchase account debit to because he's buying goods from the A. So purchase account debit to A account. Okay, done. The first general entry for the sale of goods. Then for the acceptance of it. It will be, tell me what, A account debit to
bills payable account.
All the general entries are repeated in nature. We yes. have been doing the same general entries in every question. Only thing is that we are adding more variety to the question. We are doing question based on dishonor, then this endorsement, then this time renewal. Every other thing is same.
Okay, sir.
Now for the cancellation of the bill. So in case of cancellation of bill, just opposite. Bills
payable account debit
debited to
A's account.
A account. Then for the interest, it will be just opposite. Interest account will be debited to A account. Correct?
Yes, sir.
For the payment, obviously, sir, for the payment, cash will reduce, no? So A account will be debited to cash account. Cash is reducing, A account is debiting. All right?
Yes, sir.
For the
issuance of A account debited to payable account.
This payable account, BP account. I hope it is correct for Halima as well. Halima, is this understood?
Yes.
You want me to explain this more in detail?
I got it.
Got it. All right, very good. So, okay. So this is the correct solution of the question. And this is only, I only have the solution for the drawer. And I don't have the solution for the drawee. All right, never mind. I hope you already understood this. So we can move forward to the next question. So this is the next question we will be doing here. X sells good of rupees 40,000 to Y on 1st January 2019. And on the same day, draws a bill on Y at the 3 month for the amount. Y accept it and return it to X, who discounted it on 4th January 2019 with his bank at the rate 6% per annum, right? The acceptance is dishonored on the due date and notice charges were paid by the bank being 200. On 4th of April 2019, Y accept a new bill at the 3 month for the amount then due to X together with the interest at 12% per annum. Make journal entries to record these transactions in the book of X. So there are a lot of things happening in this question. First of all, we have drawn a bill. Then we have discount this bill, and after discounting, bill is getting dishonored. After getting it dishonored, the drawee is issuing a new bill. So lot of variety is in this question. So guys, just tell me if I'll give you this question in homework, you will be able to solve this, or you want me to solve this now? Just tell me, will you be trying this question in your homework, or shall I do this now?
We'll do it homework.
Okay, you will do it in homework. So I want you to try this question. It is obviously it is comparatively difficult with the previous question as compared to the previous question, but I want you to try this question. It is not as difficult that you won't be able to solve this. You would be in a position to solve this, but I just want you to try this once. And if you won't be able to solve this, we will be doing this in the next class. All right. So for now, let's take a easy question comparatively. So, okay. Okay, guys. So, try this question. Ram owes 2000 to Mohan on 1st January 2019. On this date, he accepted a draft for the amount for 3 months. Mohan got the bill discounted at his bill at his bank 6% per annum on the due date. The bill was dishonored. Noting charges rupees 20. Ram agreed to pay 520 immediately and accept another bill for rupees for the remaining amount 3 months together with the interest at 9% per annum. This bill was met on the due date. Give the journal entry in the book of both the parties. Question is clear to all of you that there are two parties, Ram and Mohan. Ram is basically the drawee and Mohan is the drawer. All right. Ram owes 2000 to Mohan. That means Mohan is the drawer and Ram is the drawee. And Ram have issued a bill of exchange. Mohan got this bill of exchange discounted with the bank. This bill of exchange get dishonored later. Bank has to pay the noting charges rupees 20. Ram finally agreed to pay 520 out of the total whatever the bill was, and immediately basically all in all the thing is that is the in this question, bill is first getting discounted, then it is getting dishonored, then then finally our renewal is being done. So we have to do three treatment in this question. It is just similar to the previous question. So I'll be doing this question in the class. Then I have already given you one question as homework. So you will then you will find that question easy. So let's start. So let's start the journal entry in the book of Mohan. Hamadan Alima, am I clear? No.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, first of all, in the book of the Mohan, what will be the general entry? First general entry will be for the issuance of bill, right?
Yes, sir. It will be bills payable account debit to. No.
Bills, not bills payable. In the book of the drawer, that is Mohan. So bills, not bills payable
receivable
account.
Bills receivable account debit to Ram account.
Bills receivable account debit to Ram account. Perfect. Very good. Just write down the general entry. Let me know when you are done.
Done.
Halima, done?
Yes, done.
Now, Mohan got the bill discounted. So Halima will tell me what will be the general entry for the discounting of bill of exchange. What is the general entry for the discounting of bill of exchange?
Bank account debit, discounting charge debit to bills receivable account.
All right. So bank account will be debited by how much? First of all, bills receivable account will be credited. Bills receivable account will be credited by 2000, right? And bank will be charging the discounting charge of 6%. So 6% will be charged on what amount? 6% will be charged on 2000, right? So 6% of 2000 is how much? 180. Correct? 6% of 1000 is how much? Tell me. 6% of 1000 is how much? Anyone else? Halima. Tell me the discounting charge. No answer. Discounting charge will be 6% on 2000. It will be 180 rupees for the entire year. But we need to charge the discounting charge only for 3 month period. So for 3 month period, it will be how much? It will be 180 into 3/12, right?
45
rupees. Correct. 45 rupees it will be. So discounting charge will be 45. So the final general entry will be bank account debit 1955, discounting charge account debit 45 to bills receivable account 2000. Hamad, tell me, is this correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what is happening? Bill is getting dishonored on the due date and noting charge is also paid by the bank. So when bill gets dishonored, what will be the general entry in the book of the drawer? Tell me, what will be the general entry? Tell me the general entry when bill gets dishonored after discounting it with the bank. We have already done this in the last session.
Well, discounting charges, it will be a bank account debit. Discounting charges account debit. So bills receivable account.
Again, please.
Sir, after discounting charges, right?
Yeah, after discounting is done with the bank, the general entry will be
bank account debit.
No, bank is not debited. Drawee account debit to bank account, that is the general entry. That means in this, as per this question, we have to debit drawee account. And who is drawee? Ram is the drawee.
So it will be Ram account debit.
Ram account debit, correct.
To bank account.
To bank account. Perfect. So this will be the correct general entry. Ram account debit to bank account. Okay. Now noting charges is also there, so we will also have to write down the value of the noting charges. So Ram account debit, noting charges account debit to bank account. All right. Now Ram agreed to pay 520 immediately and accept the bill, another bill for the remaining. So for the part payment, we will be generalizing the part payment. So part payment received will be cash account debit to. Tell me, for the part payment, what will be the general entry, Hamad?
Cash account debit to Ram account.
Very good. And now interest will also be due for 3 month period.
Yes, sir. It will be Ram account debit to interest account.
Ram account debit to interest account. That is correct. And you will calculate. You can calculate interest of 9%, no?
Yes, sir. It will be 1,500 multiplied 9% by into 3/12.
Correct. Okay. And all right. Then on the due date, bill is being duly honored. So on the due date. So after the interest entry, we will also be doing the entry for the issuance of the new bill. So the new bill, the general entry for the issuance of new bill is bills receivable account debit to Ram, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And finally, on the due date, bill is getting honored. So cash account, bank account or cash account debit to bills receivable account. That is it. This is it. All the transactions are duly journalized in the book of the Mohan. Alima, is this understood? Do I need to solve this, guys? Please let me know. If you want me to solve this, I can solve this as well. Otherwise, I think it is easy and you can do this. Tell me.
Okay.
So guys, this is it for today's class. I have given you a similar question and I want all of you to try that question. Okay. The previous question I gave you this question in homework. So I want all of you to try this question. All right, everyone.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so guys, this is it for today's class. Thank you for attending today's session. This will be it for the accounts part. We will be taking a break of 5 minutes, then we will continue with our economics part. So those who are here for the accounts only can leave now. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, Steve, are you there? Steve, please unmute yourself and please let me know whether you are here or not.
Yes, sir, I am here.
Okay. Steve, today we won't be doing the economics class because I'm too tired and I won't be able to continue with the economics class. So let's take a break today. We will be doing more discussion in economics regarding the monopoly and oligopoly market in the next class only.